Quetzalcoatl Entertainment presents Quentin's Animation Extravaganza, episode 168. Miguel is back.
Time to shine. Everything will be alright. Everyone's excited to see you come. Quentin's Animation and Extravaganza. Lots to do. All we need now is you. Now it's time for this show to begin. Quentin's Animation Extravaganza. 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 Extravaganza.
Oh, hi! Welcome to Animation Land. As can see, I've just sent my script for chapter 59 of Hemans of Sentai Goranger to Shotaro so you can do the illustrations. My manga's getting close to the end by now, so I can hardly wait for the finale, which is chapter 84. Say, is that the mail truck? Duh, of course it is. Guess I better check my mailbox. Now let's see. Ooh, a letter from Miguel. I hadn't seen him in a few weeks. He's inviting me to lunch at El Mezcal. That's in Puget City. Well, might as well accept, since I'm starting to get to know him better. Alright! To Pewter City! Alright, Pewter City. Looks as beautiful as ever. And there's El Mezcal. Come on, let's go.
Terrific, Quentin, you made it.
Oh, I didn't expect Gordon, Susan, and Bob to be here as well, but okay. Well, we're all growing pretty fond of Miguel and thought we'd spend some time with him today. Okay, well that's interesting. Anyway, Miguel, you can already tell I got your letter. Of course, so have a seat and let's order.
Welcome to El Mezcal. What can I get for you to drink?
May I have a Sprite, por favor?
Alright. For you?
I'll have a sparkling water.
I'll have one too.
Okay. For you?
I'll go with a Diet Coke, please.
Alright, your drinks will be ready shortly.
Wow, I'm surprised you know a lot of Spanish.
Well, my mother used to be a Spanish teacher at Lenore City High School in Tennessee.
Guess you grew up near that area.
Oh, I was actually born in Knoxville at the UT Hospital. After a couple weeks, I moved to El Paso and stayed there for my first year or so. Then I moved to Fayetteville, North Carolina. Finally, I moved back to Knoxville, where I was 3 going on 4.
Wow, I'm assuming you stayed in that area until your family was killed by Gold Mask.
Yep. Anyway, going back to Spanish, I took 2 Spanish classes when I was in Farragut High School. I took them during my junior and senior years, respectively.
Oh, wow!
Yeah, funny story. I originally wanted to take German because, in my mind, Spanish overshadows every other foreign language in the world. At least here in the U.S.
I understand. I actually feel the same way, despite being a Spanish speaker myself.
Huh, that's a first. Anyway, I soon found out that the German teacher at Farragut High was very strict, something I could not bear to take, so I decided to take Spanish instead, as I had some personal experience in that language, and it was just easier in general.
Well, I guess the rest is history.
Yep.
Say, you look really excited about something. What is it?
Okay, get this. Our awful president is being investigated for an impeachment. Wow, that is something to be excited about. The vast majority of us Americans hate him due to all the damage he's done to this country. Well, let's hope he finally meets his downfall.
Wow, that was some fine dining with Gordon, Susan, Bob, and Miguel. I actually had a good time in El Mezcal, didn't you?
Hello, Quentin. Nice to see you filled with joy.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Hooper. I'm actually excited because our narcissistic tyrant of a president is being investigated for an impeachment.
Wow, what fantastic news! He probably won't be kicked out of office, but it's nice to see that the resistance against him is spreading to Congress.
Yeah, well, let's hope that he loses the election next year.
Precisely. Well, see you later.
Wow, what a perfect day to reunite with Miguel. I feel that I should see him more often, don't you?
Anyway, thanks for coming down. Stop by whenever crime attacks again, okay?
Alright, see you later.
This episode was an original story created entirely for this show, written by Quentin Cole, copyright 2019. This program is a production of Quetzalcoatl Entertainment.
This is PBS, the Public Broadcasting Service.